Hello and welcome to this special broadcast. I'm Parikshit Luthra. The much-awaited Pran Pratishtha or consecration ceremony of the Ram Janmabhoomi temple in Ayodhya has been completed, fulfilling what has been claimed as a 500-year-old wait for the homecoming of Lord Ram. It also brings to a finality a decades-old project of the BJP months ahead of the elections. Prime Minister Narendra Modi, who led the ceremony, said that the January 22nd is not a date on a calendar, but the dawn of a new era. He equated the consecration with the breaking free of a mindset of slavery and urged that every Indian's consciousness should extend from God to country and from Ram to Rashtra. The temple town of Ayodhya wore a festive look with thousands of devotees congregating from the length and breadth of India to witness what has been touted as a historic moment for the Hindus. The 8,000-strong guest list included corporate India captains, politicians, film personalities and sportspersons. For decades, the temple site had been a bone of contention between the Hindus and the Muslims and culminated into nationwide riots after the demolition of the 16th-century Babri Masjid in December 1992. In 2019, the Supreme Court, in a landmark verdict, brought the curtains down on what has been India's longest-running legal tussle and paved the way for the construction of the temple. Remember, Ayodhya has already been touted as a tourism powerhouse. According to a report by Jefferies, the temple town could attract over 50 million tourists a year. The report highlights that the $10 billion Ayodhya is now set to transport the ancient city from a sleepy town to a global religious and spiritual tourist hotspot. We will be discussing the Ayodhya opportunity in detail. First, let's listen in to snippets from Prime Minister Modi's address.
Sadiyon ki pratiksha ke baad, hamare Ram aa gaye hain. Sadiyon ka abhutpurv dhairya, anginat balidan, tyag aur tapasya ke baad, हमारे प्रभु राम आ गए हैं। इस शुभ घड़ी की आप सभी को, समस्त देशवासियों को बहुत बहुत बधाई। हमारे रामलला अब टेंट में नहीं रहेंगे। हमारे लाल रामलला अब इस दिव्य मंदिर में रहेंगे। मुझे विश्वास है प्रभु राम आज हमें अवश्य क्षमा करेंगे। मैं आभार व्यक्त करूंगा भारत की न्यायपालिका का, जिसने न्याय की लाज रख ली। वो भी एक समय था जब कुछ लोग कहते थे कि राम मंदिर बना तो आग लग जाएगी। ऐसे लोग भारत के सामाजिक भाव की पवित्रता को नहीं जान पाए। राम लला के इस मंदिर का निर्माण भारतीय समाज के शांति, धैर्य, आपसी सद्भाव और समन्वय का भी प्रतीक है।
All right, let's now go across to our guests this evening. We're joined by Ajay Bakaya, the MD of Sarovar Hotels and Resorts. Also with us, Dhruv Shringi, co-founder and CEO of Yatra.com, also with us on the program. Thank you very much, gentlemen, for being with us on this auspicious day. Let me begin with you, Mr. Bakaya. How do you see the Prime Minister's speech today, saying that the Ram Temple inauguration actually lays the foundation for the next 1,000 years of India? How do you see this milestone for the country, first of all, Mr. Bakaya?
Parisha, thank you for having me. I think Ayodhya could not have had a possible better inauguration or opening. The temple, the city led by the Prime Minister himself. It's become a strong rallying point. It's become a big part in a lot of people's lives. It's celebratory, and the Honorable Prime Minister is leading the way. So from that point of view, fascinating. How it goes on in history is something only time and history will tell. But I think as of today, it's a very momentous occasion. It's a special start. It's something that is close to the hearts of thousands and millions of devotees of Lord Ram. It's certainly a huge milestone, a big benchmark in the formation of a religious city. So it certainly goes beyond religious symbolism into the advent of a new era and a new scale altogether. Something like this has not been done for thousands of years in this country. So I think phenomenal. Could not have been a bigger or a more impactful event, and a better opening for a new city of Ayodhya. Parikshit.
Right. Dhruv Sringi, if I can come to you, how do you and Yatra.com view this as an opportunity? Over the last few months, we've been seeing major airliners making way and connecting Ayodhya on their map. A lot of tourists will also be flocking to Ayodhya over the next few months. How do you see this as the development of Ayodhya as a tourist circuit?
Sure. So thank you for having me on your show, Parikshit. But to address your question, I think from an India point of view, just seeing the kind of euphoria that one is seeing on the road, you know, just talking to other people around, it seems to be one of those moments that's bringing the country together. So it's a moment of great joy. And I think it's a great privilege for all of us in our generation to be able to witness it. So it is definitely a historic moment for the country. But more specifically for the travel industry, I think it's a seminal moment which is bringing together the ecosystem from a religious tourism perspective, if I can call it that, right? See, religious tourism always has been one of the big reasons for travel, but it's always been in the background. This has brought religious tourism to the forefront. I mean, I'm seeing, when I'm looking at the kind of profile of people who are traveling, it's no longer just the elderly who are traveling. I'm seeing so many young people also traveling for religious purposes, but it's become religious plus plus, meaning you would go to a destination, right? You might do one day of darshan, but beyond that, you will then package other activities around it to make it a more holistic holiday. It's centered around pilgrimage or that destination, but it's got other stuff with it, right? We see Amritsar is a classic example. We see Vaishno Devi as another one where, you know, you're seeing more and more side trips being planned in addition to the main darshan which people are looking at.
Right. Mr. Pakaya, let me return to you. Many hotel chains are seeing Ayodhya as a major economic opportunity. Many of them are in talks with district authorities. What about Sarovar Hotels and Resorts? What is the kind of opportunity you see? Are you looking to set up a property there in the next 36 months? Any kind of investments you've planned for the city?
Parikshit, we are operating the only branded hotel in Ayodhya today. We are operating a Radisson brand called Park Inn by Radisson. And we've been working with the owners who are from Ayodhya itself for the last many years. There are at least 15 to 20 other hotel projects, branded hotel projects that are on the anvil. So give it 5 to 6 years, you'll have a fair amount of supply. Ayodhya has gone in the right way in terms of planning. It's you got the infrastructure first, you got the roads, you got a railway network, you have the airport. So all of that is in place. We can't be asking for a lot more. And you will see plenty of hotel supply. For anyone going into the market today, I would very strongly advise a proper feasibility study, keeping in mind the number of projects that are already on the anvil. So yes, it's been a great opportunity. And it will remain a great opportunity for the next 5 years. But if there is too much supply, that can also be an issue. So I think for a fresh investor, a proper feasibility study would be very much in order. Parikshit.
Right. So you're saying 15 to 20 properties. Are you talking about the industry or are you only talking about your group, Mr. Bukhari?
No, I'm talking about the industry overall. All the brands, all the chains, everyone has got a foot in the door. Everyone's got projects in different stages of development. People have even bought land as recently as yesterday. I know our owners who've done a deal yesterday. So I think there's lots on the anvil. You know, we operate in cities like Tirupati, we operate in Vrindavan, we operate in Amritsar. All these places have large hotels that Sarovar runs. And I think an oversupply can be an impediment more than a benefit in time to come. So one just has to be careful. Land is priced sky high at the moment in Ayodhya. And anyone who hasn't invested yet would be wise to look at the overall landscape before jumping in. Parikshit?
Right. So that's an important point because right now, of course, there's a lot of interest in traveling to Ayodhya. And of course, this will stay for a few years. But what after that as a long-term tourist destination? Important and valid points there. Let me go back to Dhruv. Dhruv, Yatra.com, what is the kind of uptick you've seen in flight bookings, hotel bookings around Ayodhya?
So if I look at just more specifically, you know, what we've seen over the last 2 weeks and the kind of forward bookings that we're looking at Ayodhya right now, especially for flights, you're seeing almost a 400% increase in terms of flight bookings, right? So there is a significant amount of demand right now for Ayodhya, and not just for this particular date, but also going forward into the rest of January and then early parts of May. On the hotel side, there is still limited amount of capacity of hotels which is available in Ayodhya. But interestingly, what we are seeing is people are even looking at, you know, Lucknow as a base for travel to Ayodhya, right? Given the new highway which is there, it's about a 2-hour, 30-minute, 2-hour, 45-minute kind of drive. And Lucknow obviously has good capacity of hotels. So people are looking at Lucknow as a base and then driving down and doing a day trip to Ayodhya from there. So people are finding creative ways, right? Not just dependent on the limited amount of supply in Ayodhya right now. Also, with regards to supply in Ayodhya, the conversations that we've had with the key hotel chains, it is very likely that most of them will expand capacity quite significantly into Ayodhya over the course of the next 18 months. A number of them already have ongoing projects. And by the winter of this year, winter of 2024, we'll start seeing meaningful, good quality supply come up in Ayodhya as well.
And Dhruv, how many hotels do you expect to be coming up in Ayodhya in the next 1 year or 18 months?
See, I think in terms of the supply of quality hotels, right, and I would put, you know, 3-star, 4-star, and 5-star, you know, and chain products over there, I think we will see at least, you know, about 2,000 odd rooms come up in Ayodhya in this kind of, you know, 24-month time frame.
All right, Mr. Bukhari, one final question to you before we let you go. Currently, what is the kind of rates, tariffs you're seeing across your properties in the region, in Lucknow, places near Ayodhya, within Ayodhya itself? Till when are hotels in Ayodhya going to be fully booked out?
Rikshit, I believe that any additional branded supply in Ayodhya is at least 2 years away, 2 to 3 years, in my opinion. So very strong demand, very little supply, which means rates are going to be strong. I don't want to talk about rates which have gone on in the last 2 days or so. They're sort of unreal because there just wasn't any supply and huge demand. But we are looking at a 90% plus occupancy in our hotel, and we're looking at very sustained, strong rate structure. And I think Ayodhya it will stay that way for at least the next 3 to 4 years. That's my opinion. Parikshit?
All right. Thank you very much, Mr. Bakaya and Dhruv Sringi from Yatra.com, giving us your view on the kind of tourism potential that the temple inauguration is going to unleash for Ayodhya. We'll take a short break at this point, but when we return, we will speak about the Prime Minister's message when he spoke at the Ram Temple inauguration earlier today and what it means for the country's politics going ahead. Don't go anywhere. Our special discussion continues.
करेंगे?
आज हम सभी जय श्री राम पधार रहे हैं।